Authorities at Metropolitan International University have suspended operations to mourn the co-founder and the chairperson of the board of directors of the university, the late State Minister for Defense in charge of Veteran Affairs, Sarah Mateke Nyirabashisi. According to the document issued on Monday by the University Vice Chancellor Dr. Julius Orinaitwe, the university has resolved to suspend operations in honor of the late Sarah Mateke in memory and recognition of her immense contributions to the university. Dr. Orinaitwe says the late Mateke has been a pillar of strength and guidance to Metropolitan University, saying that her loss is deeply felt across the entire university community.
We suspended some activities. We suspended so that we can be able to mourn our promoter and founder and the chairperson of the Board of Trustees for the university.
The Gail President of Metropolitan International University, Kisoro Main Campus, Gadini Zeimana, says that students under the Bashisi Foundation scheme are worried about the next course of action following the demise of the founder.
It's been helping us to, by through paying for us, most of us, the functional fees in this institution. And as students, we are looking forward to seeing whether the university is going to continue helping us to finish the courses.
As a sign of respect, of paying respect and the attribute to the Honorable Minister, we have suspended some of activities for this week.
Metropolitan International University has three campuses, including Bara, Kampala, and Kisoro being the main campus. The recent decision by the Ministry of Education and Sports to permit learners to carry digital devices, including mobile phones, to school represents a significant turning point in Uganda's education landscape. This progressive move was championed by the Minister of Education and Sports, Mrs. Janet Museveni, during the launch of the ministry's digital agenda strategy last month. The minister also stressed the importance of cybersecurity in the implementation of the digital agenda strategy, emphasizing the need to protect learners and educators from harmful online content. Today, the officials from the Ministry of Education came out clear on the implementation of the program. Dr. Dennis Mugimba, the Ministry of Education spokesperson, clarified that in the digital agenda strategy, students and pupils are permitted to use mobile phones and digital devices in schools. However, the ministry is in the process of putting countermeasures to ensure that the use of computers and mobile devices in schools strictly serve the intended purpose of advancing the education sector.
It is actually embracing the entire education and sports sector, because we are the ministry responsible for education and sports. Then there are also systems we use to manage education service delivery, like the tool which you all know called the Education Management Information System, EMIS.
The procedural preparations that are being made by the ministry, done by the Ministry of Education and Sports. He talked about CPDs and training of teachers, but already we have started.
According to Education Ministry officials, all students and pupils in both government and private schools are barred from the use of mobile phones and digital devices in schools until the ministry rolls out the countermeasures. A total of 400 youths in the age bracket of 13 to 30 in the Busia district have been equipped with various entrepreneurship skills to enable them to fight poverty and reduce unemployment. The one-week training, which was organized by Greater Samia Bugwe Archdeaconry, empowered the youth through skills such as coffee growing, liquid soap and bar soap making, and jewelry making, among others. In his address during the climax of the training, Godfrey Chiwanda Subi, the National Resistance Movement chairperson in charge of Central, urged youth across the country to observe six pillars, which include the search for good, respect for people in the community, adopting continuous learning, love for one another, and hardworking, among others. Chiwanda also says this is the key to unlocking success.
Of life, yeah. The six spokes of life. Fear of the Almighty God, the personal relationship between a person and his creator. Because that puts an enabling environment within your heart, and to be able to be peaceful. Number two, the youth must take families seriously.
Nekesa Barbara Oundo, the NRM party treasurer, lauded the leaders of Greater Samia Bugwe Archdeaconry for coming up with the initiative of youth skilling. She says it helps to prepare the minds of the youth to benefit from government programs like Parish Development Model and MUGA.
If we bring interventions like PDM and MUGA, we need a prepared population for them to benefit from these interventions. So what they are doing is to prepare, first of all, our people. I have always grappled with the issue of why is it that when you look at Wicked academic-wise, we produce academic giants. But when it comes to the ranking in poverty, we have a slot there.
Auma Winifred and Martha Auma, among the attendees of the one-week training and youth conference, they are thankful for the skills acquired.
But what I have learned here and what I have helped our youth use here, we have now got courage. Like those people who say that their parents have left them, those people who were telling us their backgrounds, who some of them were engaged here and some of them they have now the ability that sometimes you first pass through the hard situation and time comes when you